I bought an IDASEN IKEA standing desk which can be moved up and down with a push of a button, and I love it. But there is one major problem. The IKEA desk have no memory and I cannot set it to a predefined fixed height every time I want that. However, thanks to Home Assistant, ESPHome and an ESP32 device, I made my IDASEN IKEA desk smart. Just a quick story before I start the actual implementation. I'm working from home most of the time lately and I spend most of my time sitting on a chair. The problem is that my neck and back are not very happy about that fact, as they started to shudder and hurt. That is why I tried to change my old chair with a better one, but then my desk turns out to be low in height and I started to look around for a new desk as well. I had read somewhere about the standing desks and their benefits, so I dig into the topic more and I decided to go for it. It turns out that IKEA is selling one of the best desks with motors, so you can have a stand desk and when you get tired to lower it down and to sit on a chair as usual. These IKEA desks doesn't come cheap, quite the opposite. They are freaking expensive, but I prefer to spend my money now on a standing desk than later on doctors. So, I bought one. Quick tip here, if you decide to buy similar stand desk from IKEA, have in mind that they have two very similar models. One is called IDASEN and the other is called BEKANT. Try to avoid BEKANT as it is problematic and it is not as stable as IDASEN. I test them both and I read and watched some reviews, so to save you some time, go for IDASEN standing desk and ignore the other. The IDASEN standing desk have an up and down switch and it have a Bluetooth, but as I said in the beginning of the video, there is no memory and you cannot move the desk to a certain fixed height, which is not such of a big deal. But as I love to automate things, I decided to try adding the IDASEN standing desk to my Home Assistant. Here is what I use to make my IKEA standing desk smart. First thing is a D1 mini ESP32 board that costs around $5 in AliExpress website. Also, a micro USB cable and optionally an USB adapter. Amazon and AliExpress affiliate links to everything that is needed can be found in the video description. That is if you want to check the prices. Apart from the parts that I just said, a working Home Assistant with ESP Home dashboard is also needed. I'm talking about Home Assistant all the time, because it is such a great free smart home hub. If you still don't have it, or you want to understand what are the 4 official and supported ways to get Home Assistant, plus one secret and super easy way to start it on your PC in under 5 minutes, go and register for my free webinar, which is available on my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Before I continue to the installation of the ESP Home software on the D1 mini ESP32 device, I have to pair my IDASEN desk with my computer or with my phone, so I can get the Bluetooth MAC address of the desk and later to use that address in the ESP Home configuration. I've heard that the BLE Scanner 4.0 app for iOS or Android can help extracting the Bluetooth address of the IDASEN desk. I'm pretty sure that getting the Bluetooth MAC address from Windows OS is as easily possible. But to be honest, I don't know what are the possible methods there. If you happen to know that, let me know in the comment section below. Anyways, I'm using macOS and I'll use the Desk Remote Control Mac application to get the IDASEN Bluetooth MAC address. And this is the ESP Home IDASEN Desk Controller GitHub page. The author of this page is Julian. Great work, Julian. Greetings from my side. All the credits for this incredible project is going to you and your supporters and contributors. I'll scroll down a bit of this GitHub page until I see these links. I have to use either IDASEN controller app for macOS or desk remote control app to extract the MAC address of my IDASEN desk. Both of these applications will work. I'll try with this second one, Desk Remote Control. It opens the MAC App Store because this app is uploaded there. I already downloaded it and I'll just click Open. Here it is. Currently the app is searching for my desk and now I have to put my IDASEN standing desk into pairing mode, and this is very easy. I have to hold the Bluetooth button until the blue LED starts flashing. Then I'll hit search and my desk is immediately found. I'll click connect and I'm ready. I can move up and down my desk using this app, but this is not what I wanted. I want to get the MAC address, and for this I'll return back to the GitHub page of the Julian and I'll copy as instructed this command. Then I'll open my terminal and I'll paste the command inside. It will list all of my Bluetooth devices and where is my desk? Here it is, and this is the MAC address that I need. I will copy this and I'll store it somewhere because I'll use it later in the ESPHome configuration. Now I have everything that is needed to install the ESPHome software on my D1 Mini ESP32, so I can make the IDASEN IKEA desk smart. Here is the ESPHome configuration that I use. While I'm inside my home assistant, I'll open the ESPHome dashboard. Of course, this is not the only possible way to have ESPHome dashboard, but it is one of the easiest. I have a video where I'm showing the other possible ways to get ESPHome dashboard, and I'll link it right here. Inside the ESPHome dashboard, I'll click on this new device button. On this dialog, I'll click continue. I'll type a name of my ESPHome device, IDASEN for example, and I'll enter my Wi-Fi credentials, the name and the password. Then I'll click next. As device type, I'll select ESP32 and I'll click next. My ESPHome device is created, but I'll skip the installation part for now because I want to edit the configuration of it. I'll click edit. And I'll delete everything here. I'll select all and I'll delete it. Then I'll paste my YAML configuration. Here it is. If you are new to this YAML and ESPHome stuff, the things that you want to change are only the name and the Bluetooth address of your IDASEN desk here. Optionally, you can also change the other names for these binary sensors, for this cover. But if you are doing this for the first time, I can suggest only to change the MAC address with yours, the one that IDASEN Desk is having. Then I'll click Save. But before I hit install, I'll connect my D1 Mini ESP32 with the USB cable to the device where ESPHome dashboard is installed. And then I'll click install. I'll select this third option, plug into the computer running ESPHome dashboard. I'll select the server port and the installation begins. And the ESPHome installation is now done. Everything seems okay for now. And as you can see here, I have the height of my desk and I have the speed, which means that everything is working. If that's not the case, try to restart the D1 Mini ESP32 and to hold the Bluetooth button of the IDASEN desk. Okay, I'll stop this. I'll close this. And I can see that my IDASEN device is online. That means I can try to add it to my home assistant. My IDASEN ESPHome device is ready to be added in home assistant. So I can start making home assistant automations and scripts and scenes that will move the IDASEN desk to my desired positions. I'll go to the overview section. I'll press the C button and I'll start typing integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations. Inside this integration list, I can see my IDASEN device discovered by Home Assistant and I just have to click configure. If you don't see it, try to add an ESPHome integration and you'll be able to configure it that way. manually. But because I have it here, I'll just click configure, submit, and my device is successfully configured. I can select an area here and I can click finish. This is my device, one device with three entities. This is a desk connection sensor which is currently connected, and this is a desk moving binary sensor which is currently not moving. Currently my desk is at the highest possible position and I cannot move it more in that direction. But if I move it with my button, you can see that the desk moving sensor is changing its state. And now the up arrow is activated. If I press it, I can move my desk up. The down arrow is not working and the stop button, I think it's not working as well. I'll test it. I'll go down a bit. Then if I click up, I think it's working. Yes, it seems that the stop cover button is working. The only thing that is not working is the down button or the close cover button. One quick remark before I move on. I'm using a custom ESPHome component that creates a Bluetooth bridge between IKEA IDASEN Desk and the D1 Mini ESP32 device. However, the code is little outdated, as there are no new commits in the last 6 months or so. A lot of Bluetooth changes happened in the ESP Home and Home Assistant space during these last 6 months. That means the project needs a little push to stay on track. I will leave a link to the GitHub repo of this project, so if you have the ability and time, maybe you can help and make it up to date again. Anyways, as end result, I managed to extract from the current state of the project a cover entity with two binary sensors in Home Assistant. Usually the Home Assistant covers can be moved up and down, but in this case, with the configuration that I have and after all the tests that I did, I managed to make the desk to move only up. Maybe it's just me and it will work just fine for you, I don't know. Nevertheless, I found a workaround, which is to use a cover set position Home Assistant service, and that way I can move the desk up and down to a specific percentage from 0 to 100. The best of all is that I can use this approach in Home Assistant automations, scripts and scenes. On top, I managed to find a great custom cart in Home Assistant Community Store, which have sit and stand buttons that are also working fine. But enough sweet talks, I'll first show you how I created a quick Home Assistant script that set a custom height of the IDASEN standing desk, and then I'll show you the custom cart from Hacks. From this window I can create an automation, scene or script, and I'll show you how I can create a script. I'll click on this plus button and I'll select this set IDASEN desk position. As a name, I can type whatever I want. For example, stand position. I can select an icon. For example, arrow up bolt. And as a sequence, I'll drag the position to whatever value I wish. For example, 95%. That's it. Now when this script is executed, my desk will go to the 95% of its max possible height. I'll save the script and I'll click on the three dots menu and I'll select run script. And my desk is moving. I can create another script for my sitting position. I can use this in scenes and I can use this in automations. This is the custom cart available in Hacks or Home Assistant Community Store that I told you about. If you don't have Hacks or you want to know more about it, you can check this video of mine. To find the cart, you have to search for Linak desk cart in the front end section of the Hacks and to install that custom cart. Because I didn't manage to get the current desk height sensor working, this digit right here on the cart is not changing. The up button is working, but down button is down, and out of order. Fortunately, stay and sit buttons are working just fine, and setting a desired height is easily possible by just editing the card. Next optional thing is a 3D case for the D1 Mini ESP32. I'll share a link to this 3D model in the video description if you want to print the same. Of course, it is also fine to leave the D1 Mini as it is without any cover. That is, if it's not fighting with your feng shui design. One more thing, because I'm constantly using some smart home words and abbreviations that may sound strange to you, I made a smart home glossary in a form of a PDF document. I want to give you that document free of any charge, so it can help you further in your smart home journey. Inside that glossary, you will find simple but useful explanations of a lot of smart home stuff. Basically, everything that I can think of. So go to my website and download it right now. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!